Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is also prophesied in the Vedas. He is prophesied in Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 127, mantra number 1 to 14. It is called as Kuntap Suktas. Kuntap means hidden gland in the abdomen. That means the meaning of these verses are hidden, and you'll come to know about it later on. Kuntap also means free from misery, also means peace, similar to Islam. It's also related to the center of the earth. And we know Makkah is the center of the earth. And Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 96, that the first place of worship was Bakkah, which is another name for Makkah. Time will not permit me to go through all the 14 mantras. I'll just briefly speak about the first four mantras. Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 127, mantra number 1 says, He is Narashansa. He is Kaurama, who has been protected from 60,090 enemies. Mantra number 2 says, He is a camel riding Rishi. Mantra number 3 says, He is Mama Rishi. Mantra number 4 says, He is Vashyavesh Reb. The first mantra says, He is Narashansa. Nar in Sanskrit means a human being or a man. Shansa means Prashansa, praiseworthy. A man who is praiseworthy, which is exactly the translation of the Arabic word Muhammad, which was the name of the last and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It further says, He is Kaurama. One of the meaning of Kaurama is a prince of peace. And a beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a prince of peace. The other meaning is an immigrant. And we know Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, migrated from Makkah to Medina, and he was an immigrant. It further says, He will be protected from 60,090 enemies. And we know the population of Makkah that was against Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was approximately 60,000. Mantra number 2 says, He will be a camel riding Rishi. No Indian Rishi or a Brahmin will ever ride a camel, because riding a camel is prohibited for a Brahmin. It's mentioned in Manusmriti, chapter number 11, verse number 202, that a Brahmin will not ride a camel or an ass. Therefore, it has to be a prophet who is a foreigner. Third mantra says, He is Mama Rishi or Maharishi. Mama, some verses say Muhammad, some say great Rishi. Mantra number 4 says, He is Reb. Reb means one who praises, which is the meaning of the other name of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One who praises in Arabic is called as Ahmad, which was the other name of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is also prophesied in Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 21, mantra number 6. It says, it speaks about the battle of Ahzab, the battle of allies, and it says that He will be protected from 10,000 enemies, and He will win the battle without fighting it. He will be a Karu. Now, Karu in Sanskrit means a person who praises. In Arabic, it means Ahmad, which is another name for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It says He will win the battle without fighting it. Talking about the battle of Ahzab, which was won without fighting it. And we know the approximate population, the enemies at that time, were 10,000. It further says in Atharva Ved, book number 20, hymn number 21, mantra number 7, that Almighty God will overthrow 20 kings, and He will protect the Abandhu from 60,099 enemies. Abandhu in Sanskrit means an orphan. The other meaning of Abandhu means praiseworthy, which is the translation of Muhammad into English, peace be upon him. So Abandhu in Sanskrit, if you translate to Arabic, means Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It says that Almighty God will overthrow 20 kings. And we know that there were approximately 20 chieftains in Makkah at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam won all of them. And the enemies against the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that time was approximately 60,000. The same prophecy is also repeated in Rig Veda, book number 1, hymn number 53, mantra number 9. But the Sanskrit word used is Sushrama. Sushrama also means one who is praiseworthy, which is the meaning of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.